Let's talk about Poekies. Hi, this is Mark from Tarantuhala. In our hobby, there is a lot of diversity. There are many species available in the market, but one of the most popular ones are the Poecilotherias. Poecilotherias have a pretty nasty reputation when it comes to their venom, when it comes to their speed, but there are some facts about Poecilotherias that you might not have known. So let's check them out. The name Poecilotheria was described after some changes in 1885 by Eugène-Louis Simon. The name Poecilotheria is a combination of two Greek words. First, poekios, which means spotted or diverse, and therion, which means beast. There are 22 entries for the genus Poecilotheria in the World Spider Catalog, from which 7 are synonyms. As of 2019, all Poecilotheria species are considered to be in danger, endangered in nature. So if you are a keeper, you need to have a document that they are legally coming from a breeder and they are bred in captivity. This led to some turmoil in 2019. This genus is very popular and a lot of keepers had them before they were added to the list of endangered species. The species on my left here, so the Poecilotheria metallica, is critically endangered, and without the help of terrarium fans, spider keepers, this species would probably die out pretty soon. They only live in woodland regions in Chennai on around 100 square kilometers. What's also interesting is that this species is breeding pretty well in enclosures by spider enthusiasts, so we are keeping this thing alive. Fun fact, the English name Guti Sapphire Ornamental comes from the place called Guti. Probably the woodlands were forested and this one was shipped by accident. And that's how we got the name Guti Blue Sapphire Tarantula. Poecilotheria species are old world tarantulas, so they do not have urticating hairs. They compensate that lack of defensive mechanism by a very strong venom. Poecilotherias have a pretty nasty bite. And this is a bite pretty strong even for old world tarantulas. Please keep them with care. They are not beginner tarantulas. The Poecilotherias are also one of those genus which cannot be kept legally in North Rhine-Westphalia in Germany. Since the 1st of January 2021, there is a law which prohibits to keep very venomous animals, among which are, for example, Latrodectus and Poecilotherias. There were some restrictions for previous owners, but yep, those who want them after the law came to North Rhine-Westphalia, sadly, there is no possibility, as far as I know. If you are from those regions, let me know if this is correct or maybe there are some changes. I don't know, let me know. The Poecilotheria subfusca has two variants, two forms. The Poecilotheria highland and lowland, which comes from the elevation where they live in. And they adapted to those new environments. For example, the highland is smaller and has a darker coloration to absorb more sunlight. Poecilotheria metallica also was thought to have a different form, the so-called dark form, which turned out to only be a trick from sellers to sell you old female specimen of the Poecilotheria metallica. So don't fall for that trick. In most cases, there are two nymphatic stadiums when the small spiderlings are emerging from their eggs. But there are four Poecilotheria species which have a third stadium, the third nymphatic stadium. Those species are the Poecilotheria formosa, Miranda, Metallica, and Tigrina verselli. Those are probably adaptations to the natural habitat to ensure more spiderlings survive. The nymphs are growing during dry periods in the places they are living. By delaying the time they are switching to larvae stadium, they also enhance the chance that they can catch prey which emerges in the moist season. So there you go, some facts about Poecilotheria which you may or may not have known. If you like what you saw, like the video, subscribe to my channel and ring the bell, leave a comment, let me know what you like, what you don't like, and maybe some improvements to the channel. And we'll see you in the next video. See ya!